Now available on Tata Sky channel number 526.
Our focus on toxic lakes in the city of Bengaluru continues here at Magic Bricks now after the dismal sight of the frothing Bellandur Lake raised serious questions on the situation of the lakes in the IT city and the inaction of the government. Resident groups are leading the drive to preserve the dying lakes of Bengaluru. Rahul Dayama gets us this ground report.
The situation of lakes here in Bengaluru have grabbed national and international headlines talking about the poor apathy that lakes have seen. I'm now here at Bellandur Lake, that was the epicenter of public furore really. While government action is in place, remember 200 crores was allocated by BBMP and the state government has embarked a separate budget to clean lakes, especially the Bellandur Lake. As you can see behind me, a part of the lake has been blocked by debris to really ensure that a bridge is constructed in the front to ensure that water easily flows. But residents, the surrounding areas, the Bellandur Lake group and Wildfield Rising group have got in touch with IISC and prepared a report to ensure and talk about the condition of this lake. Silt is really a major issue as far as Bellandur Lake is concerned, untreated sewage water being left in. I in fact spoke to Professor Ramachandra of IISC to know the status of this lake and what interesting insights have this study put up.
As I understand, this lake has not been managed for the last 30 or 35 years. That means the silt has deposited for the last 30 or 35 years. We need to remove that. We have the topographic map of Survey of India, which gives the depth profile in 1970, which shows that the maximum depth in this lake is about 30 feet, or 10 meters. And today when we monitor the lake, it ranges from 0.5 to the 5.4 meters. Okay? So now that means if I assume that 2 meter is the average thing, I see about 7.2 million the cubic meter of silt accumulated in the lake, which amounts to about 1,800 crores, see, which can be used as a sand. In case you are not willing to use it as a sand, you can manufacture the brick, because earlier in the lake bed you would have seen that people manufacturing the brick. The value of that would be 2,000 crores, which is about 20 billion rupees.
So this is indeed the largest lake. In fact, the water table that you mentioned, I want to touch upon that, 1,200 to 1,400 feet. You throw up an interesting fact that if silt is managed well, it can in fact recharge ground. What sort of an impact will we see in terms of recharging groundwater if the lake is revived correctly?
See, if the lake is revived correctly, as you put it, one is the recharge ability will increase. The second is the contamination coming to the lake will come to an end. That means we should not allow the untreated sewage entering the lake. The sewage that is generated in each catchment should be handled locally. We should treat that sewage, and only treated sewage should come to the lake. In the process, you see the lake water also gets, clean, and surrounding borewell also gets the better quality. So the day when all of us demand for the clean environment, I think government has to do it. And that's what Article 21 of the Indian Constitution says. We all are supposed to enjoy clean air, water and environment. Our children should get a clean water. At least my generation should move in that direction, providing clean water to the next generation.
You can watch live TV on our website mbnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at Magic Bricks Now. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.